means that you have an outside baptism. Watch this. That means that you've been in the aura of his presence and you felt the water, I feel God, splashing and sprinkling on you. And so you left, never going to the altar to receive the infilling of the power of the Holy Ghost, which down gets down on the inside of you. What are you talking about, Pastor Jill? I'm glad you're asking a question. Watch this. When the people in the Old Testament began to be with God, they had God and the Bible says that the people begin to cry out, we want a king, we want a king. But they had the king right there with them. And God still wasn't enough for them. Now watch the text. The Bible begins to teach us that. Then Jesus came on the scene. But before Jesus came on the scene, they had the Holy Ghost. They had the Spirit of God. And the Spirit of God only rested upon them. When you begin to read the Old Testament, the Bible begins to teach you that the Holy Spirit rested upon them, and after he finished using them, he lifted himself up and so that he can use whomever would avail themselves to be used by him. Well, it's the same way now. There's some of us where the Holy Spirit will rest upon us tonight, and you catch us next week and we don't have nothing.
All right.
And that's because we are walking in the experience of a John the Baptist, now dispensation baptism. But God told me to tell you tonight that he brought you to this place to introduce you to the theme of this conference. And that is why I want you to endow me. When you begin to think about an endowment, endow means you got to get down on the inside. And God wants you to know right now that as you begin to open up your spirit, open up your mouth, and open up your heart, it's like a house for the Holy Spirit to come on in. I hear God say, make room for me. You go right back to the first baptism. Man, that you're at the altar every Tuesday, every Wednesday, and every Friday, repenting for something that God don't even remember. Unless the Bible lies. The Bible lies with it. He said, I throw into the sea of, I know you know there's seven seas, but there's eight seas. He said, I throw it into the sea of forgetfulness, never to remember it again. Somebody shout it down. put you in bondage. Have you about ready to commit suicide, backslide, turn away, walk away, walk around? That's because you've been baptized by John the Baptist. But I know it's not going to sound too nice, but they chopped his head off. He's stupid. Why are you laughing at that part? That's your son. That's your child. He laughed at the wrong time. I said, they chopped his head off. He said, really, dog? Really? They chopped his head off. I wonder, I said, now, why would God allow John the Baptist, after so much work, for him to be used as an example? And they didn't just swat him out. They planned to chop his whole head off and then put it on a platter and present his head to somebody else as a gift. Because the head is the gift. And so the enemy has tried to chop off all of the men. Put the head on a platter, give it to some chick, and they walk away from God. Kill their whole spirit, kill their assignment, kill their ministry, kill their vision, kill their tenacity, kill their focus, because some chick asked for their head. Now watch this. So God allows this to happen as an example to let us know that it's still happening now. Yes. So what are we to do with this? Keep telling the story. The story didn't end there, because John the Baptist already knew his plight. He knew that he had to die, because the Bible says that he was a forerunner. He prepared the way. He says, prepare ye the way. Watch this. For there's one coming greater than I. So he had to go out like that in order to leave a greater message. But when everybody starts preaching about John the Baptist, they preach a message of sorrow instead of giving you an understanding of what his head means today. We can't allow our heads to be cut off and put on a platter to present them to our enemies so that they can do whatever they want with it. Now, the Bible never said what she did with the head. I'm just going to leave that to your imagination. It never said so. So I can't give you no revelation on that. But what I can say is there was no great significance to her afterwards. Except for now, she has a trophy that's not valuable. She has a trophy that's not valuable. But now the head, which is Jesus, comes on the scene. And he says, with me, I'll give you something that John the Baptist couldn't give you. John the Baptist didn't have power. He had influence. Yeah, he didn't have power. So the difference between influence and power. But he set it up. So for those of us that have influence, I felt God right there. Know how to work the power.
All right.
Because you can have power and don't know how to work it. You ever see somebody that's just power struck? They got all this position of power. Don't know what the heck they do. That is so frustrating. Just like your boss, you smarter than she is. That make you so mad. And they got all these zeros on their check. Don't that make you tight? That just really takes you to a place. Why? That's because you're not working that power. My mother told me, she said, stop showing people how smart you are. Then you get mad when they ask you to do things. If you, the one that's dumb, they hired you for one job, now you're doing 8 jobs. You're gonna show them everything that you know how to do. Watch this. Now they're not gonna promote you. What you say, son? You're gonna get the same pay and you're gonna be expected to do more. As soon as you decide to put your wig on right, and you feel like you don't wanna do it no more, they fire you, hire Joanne, and pay her more. I'm teaching you something. We did the hauling a few minutes ago. Take what God has given you and use it. He has empowered you tonight with another measure of His presence. Pray for the anointing for me. Everyone stand. Endow me. I can't be concerned about my neighbor. I can't be concerned about my neighbor right now. But I need you to endow me. Pour out another measure of your anointing on me. I'm going to do a mass prayer, corporate prayer, right where you're at. Holy Spirit is going to fall on you if you let Him.